You've seen the headlines. A corrupt official embezzles more than $1 million from a cash-strapped school district. A corrupt sheriff orders his deputies to work on his barn. But what causes a public official to misbehave? Experts break it down like this. You have what experts call the classical view, that officials misbehave because the pleasure and rewards of misbehaving outweigh the punishments and potential of getting caught. Looking at corruption this way points towards some solutions. More audits, more news coverage, more law enforcement investigations, more scrutiny and punishment. And there's the ethical view, that a public official fails to understand the morality of a corrupt act, why it's wrong and can harm others. This also points toward possible solutions, intensive and repetitive ethical training programs that make it clear that corruption is morally wrong. And three, the positive approach, which says peer pressure and other external forces make it easier for people to make corrupt decisions. Intensive ethics training and more enforcement can help here too. And finally, there's the structural approach, which pins corruption on a culture that promotes bad behavior, usually because of a crooked leader. Think bad sheriffs and mayors who foster a culture of corruption that encourages underlings to misbehave, where corruption is normal. So which one is the cause? Well, experts say it's often a mix of one or two, or all of the above. The important things to remember is that corruption is less likely to flourish in communities with watchdogs. We're talking about news organizations, auditors, and law enforcement. And also, if left unchecked, corruption can spread like a virus.